Trade finance is attractive in a rising rate environment because trade finance transactions are typically indexed or set at a spread to 1 or 3 month LIBOR. So in a rising rate environment, it offers investors pure access to the floating rate market. Within the floating rate continuum, trade finance represents a very unique point where it offers similar spreads to the leverage loan market, but with the same type of volatility as traditional investment grade floating rate notes. In addition, trade finance has low to negative correlation to other financial assets, including leverage loans. The outlook for trade finance in 2017 is certainly going to have a lot of headline risk and will be in the news. That being said, the expectation is that merchandise trade will be about $19 trillion in 2017, 80% of which will require some sort of financing. So most likely, if some of the things go ahead that are in the news these days, the most likely scenario is not that trade's going to fall off a cliff or end, or the trade volumes will decrease, because at the end of the day, people need food to eat. They need to be able to build their homes, heat their homes, drive their cars. The volume of trade, the volume of goods, the volume of things that need to flow around the world will remain the same. What could change, and what would most likely change, is the composition of that trade. So instead of Chinese buying soybeans from the US, for example, they will start to buy them more from Brazil or Ukraine. The so-called south-to-south trade is where trade finance really comes in handy, as it offers these buyers and sellers of goods efficient access to capital markets.